This is hectic. A video on social media of high school students in Louisiana. It shows them making racist comments and using the N-word. It's led to two arrests in Houma, Louisiana.
Right there are everywhere. They ran out of chicken because
in the video, at least two Terrebonne High School students on and off camera are chanting and even singing the N-word many times. Next, the two white teens that were in the video, they were the voices on the video, they panned to two black students calling them the slur. The two students were charged with hate crimes, inciting a riot and cyberbullying on October 26th. The police went to the high school on Wednesday to arrest these teenagers. The Houma Police Department will not tolerate this type of behavior, and this incident is still under investigation. We would like to encourage parents to have a conversation with their children about what occurred today and find out if they were affected by it. We would also like to encourage everybody to be patient and allow the proper authorities to handle this situation as the investigation continues. So those police officers went to the school to arrest the children. Then they say, you know, everybody be patient, let us investigate. Here's the thing, everybody has seen the video. We don't have to be patient and wait for an investigation because we can see what's happened. And it's really a shame that the police love to protect people who are doing terribly racist things in the community. This is Lieutenant Travis Theroit who made that statement. Terrebonne Parish School Superintendent Bubba Orgeron released a statement as well. Terrebonne Parish School is aware of a student video with despicable language and thoughts. This type of behavior and disgusting display of content will never be tolerated by our school system and has been immediately addressed by the school district and proper authorities. So here is Bubba Orgeron. We have NAACP Terrebonne Parish Chapter President Jerome Boykin, who released a statement about this as well, who said, the most important thing, I think, it sends a message to the community from the school standpoint that it won't be tolerated, and from law enforcement that it won't be tolerated also. Yeah, I think that's really important because as we see kids who are teenagers, these are not adults yet. Clearly they've been taught these things in their homes, in the household. And we've got to make sure that we don't have kids harming other kids in the schools, which is supposed to be a place for learning, not a place where you're met with terribly racist rhetoric. The kids hopefully will be all right. You know, we've seen in a lot of schools across the country, students organizing walkouts when they have school policies they don't like. But these kind of situations between, you know, two students and a group of black students, these are not the type of things that get a lot of news coverage, but happen all too frequently in the United States, especially in the American South. Rayyvana, what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, school should be a place where students feel safe and they can focus on learning and socializing. It should not be a place where they're being subject to racial abuse, discrimination, because when that happens in schools, the schools no longer, you know, become a safe, comfortable place for those students, which impedes their ability to learn. I mean, if you're constantly looking over your shoulder, you're afraid that someone's gonna come up and call you a slur, you're not gonna be able to do well in your studies, you're not gonna be able to focus. And now you're creating an environment that students don't even wanna go to. So it's good that they did take action. You know, I don't think that we should have to wait any longer. I mean, the video is extraordinarily clear. You know, this was a racist abuse of these students inciting an attack. You know, everyone who had heard it, everyone who's seen it, knows that, you know, they should be more, you know, forthright. If they have to do an investigation, they do, but I mean, it shouldn't take very long. I would like to see them, you know, come forward in the next day or two, you know, giving, you know, more details to the public about what their next steps are going to be.
And we do have that video. I'm wondering, are we able to play this video? All right, we're gonna show you all this video. We did get it exclusively, but now we've seen it posted to social media. And the police said to withhold your judgments, but you be the judge. Let's watch.
Right there. There are everywhere.
Hey, you
they ran out of chicken.
Those are kids, man. It's clear as day what's going on in that video. All right, the truth is indisputable, and the truth is in that video.